Okay, now we will discuss about Excel sheets. Okay, we have shared with you both the Excel sheets for paper 1 and paper 2. And as we have discussed in the previous slides in this session, that there are total 5 tables in the Excel sheets which are important. First table being the weightage calculation table, and 4 tables are pertaining to blueprint preparation. Okay, let's discuss Excel sheet templates. Here, if you opened both the Excel sheets, there are 2 spreadsheets here, weightage paper 1, blueprint paper 1, and here there is one weightage paper 2 and blueprint paper 2 in both the Excel sheets, right? So in paper 1, you will see that the groups of competencies as per MOH's distribution is already given for paper 1 and paper 2, right? So here basic biochemistry cell, extracellular matrix, enzymes and clinical enzymology, chemistry and metabolism of carbohydrates, and so on, including the investigation techniques and foundation of communication, that is EDCOM module, is also included, because there is one compulsory question on EDCOM module for 5 marks. So that is SAQ, one compulsory SAQ is there. So that has to be included, right? Otherwise it will be a skewed one, and we will have to, you know, again go back and give allocation for EDCOM module. So that is already included. And the teaching hours through that EDCOM module, along with the teaching hours we have given for investigation techniques, is also included. There is one compulsory question on investigation technique as well. Okay, so we have included that. Now see this table, this column where we have to write the teaching hours. Suppose for this basic biochemistry cell and extracellular matrix group of competency, there are 2 teaching hours, one for cell and one for extracellular matrix, right? So total 2 teaching hours have been depicted here. And the basic sciences clinical application rating, we have chosen it for the complete group of competency as 1. So 2 and 1, this gives you the combined weightage of 0.08, and the percentage weightage being 5.40 will be the percentage, total percentage. And as we are, you know, setting this question paper for this 117 marks, so the marks allocation for this group of competency comes out to be 6.3. So 6.3 marks will be based on that SAIL and ECM. Okay. See, for other groups also, let's take an example here, the xenobiotics. Xenobiotics, we have given 1 teaching hour, 1 lecture, and rating 1 also. Here it comes out to be 5.1 marks for that group of competency. Take one metabolism group, chemistry and metabolism of carbohydrates. See here, for all the metabolisms, carbohydrate, lipid, protein, and along with that we have one that group, molecular biology and genetics. Okay, for that we have given teaching us 9. So 9 lectures will be there for metabolism, in 2 being for chemistry and 7 for metabolism group. So the group of competency is showing you the 9 teaching hours, and as it has majorly that metabolism part will be having, you know, diseases, so a lot of clinical application is there, and that's why the group has 3 rating for clinical application. So this 9 and 3, as that is the combined criteria, you will see that it is 0.29 will be the combined weightage, 20.34% will be the percentage given to that group, and 23.8 around maximum, right? So if it is having 2-3 metabolism groups, so 23.8 here also, 23.8, so these 2 groups will be having maximum weightage. If you understand the combined weightage now, the teaching hours as well as the weightage rating has given you this kind of weightage here. Otherwise, previously when we were not using the teaching hours, the weightage distribution was totally skewed only based on the clinical application. And the topics which demand, you know, teaching hours, and it makes some basis of the knowledge for the students, was not considered. Now it is considered, and the complete skewness has been removed. Same thing here for the paper 2 as well, for combined weightage. go to the weightage table of paper 2, you will see that the groups of competencies is already made, protein group, then integration and starvation, nucleotide metabolism, vitamins, then water electrolyte balance and acid base balance, these are clubbed together, mineral metabolism, hemoglobin chemistry and metabolism are clubbed together. So you'll find that the major topics like metabolism have got maximum weightage, and which we want, right, to set a proper question paper. So that skewness is removed and you can stick to this weightage, because that weightage has been validated and we are using this weightage since 2 years when the CBME came. Okay, so it is properly weightage, you don't have to change the readings here, and follow this weightage for your paper setting. Now this weightage, whatever is put here, has been integrated in blueprint paper 2 Excel sheet. These two Excel sheets are linked together, and whatever you do in your weightage calculation sheet, it will appear in blueprint also. Come to table number 1 as per the sequence. We can take paper 1 and paper 2 intermittently. So the process is completely same, right? So whatever we are doing for paper 1, we have to, you know, replicate that for paper 2 as well. So we can take paper 2 or paper 1. But for paper 1, I have already made one blueprint so that you understand the process a complete way. And for paper 2, I haven't set. So paper 2, I will use for making the entries, and paper 1, I will show you the ready-made blueprint prepared. Come to table number 1 of paper 2. As I have already told you that we have to make entries in yellow boxes or yellow cells. Here I have put 50, 25 and 25. You can change it, but that is not required because this is phase 1 and biochemistry. So we have to keep it 50, 25 and 25, and core being 100% and non-core being 0%. Then this is table number 2, which gives you a proper idea about the spread of weightage and the marks as per the criteria. Then come to table number 3, that is marks per each question type and total number of questions. Here you will see that 20, 11 BAQs, then 9 SAQs and 3 LAQs are to be set. Here 1 mark per MCQ, then 2 mark per BAQ, 5 per SAQ and 10 per LAQ has to be entered here. And come to table number 4 here, you will see that the complete blueprint is empty. These are the places where you need to put the values depending on the LAQ or SAQ or whatever type of question you want to set for the given question paper, right? Suppose let's take an example here, chemistry and metabolism of protein. Yeah, now I'll put entries here. Suppose I'm thinking about one question on protein metabolism, and I can choose any, you also can choose any depending on your requirement. I'll choose to ask 4 mark recall question on protein. So I'm putting 4 here, but out of 10 there are 6 marks remaining. So I'll think that I can ask 3 mark comprehension now. So let's put comprehension ke liye 3 marks. So 3 marks for comprehension, and what is remaining? 3 marks for application. So I'll put 3 marks for application as well. So total, if you see, the total is 4 plus 3 plus 3, so 10 marks, right? And here the values have changed now. 10 marks out of those 30 marks allocated to LAQ has been used, and 1 LAQ has been set out of those 3 LAQs. So in this way you can set LAQs and then SAQs, okay? And I can show you the completed blueprint in this way. Come to paper 1 here. So like I have shown you, I have chosen here in this paper 1 to set LAQ on clinical enzymology and enzyme group, then carbohydrate group and lipid group. Okay, so these LAQs have been set, and you can see the tick mark coming up here. So total 30 marks and total 3 LAQ have been set here. Okay, and then SAQ part here. There are 2 compulsory clinical cases to be asked. So choose on what topic you are going to use. But I will recommend you to set SAQ first on the topics which are on which the LAQ has not been set. Okay, so choose the topics or group of competencies. These are the group on which I have not set LAQs. So set LAQs on those topics first, and then if weightage is permissible, so these are the total marks allocated to these content areas. Okay, and these are the marks coming out when you are making entries in this complete table. Okay, so check whether it is not exceeding or underrating it. So 5 marks, 1 SAQ on foundation of communication. So we have make it dark here so that you can only make 1 SAQ in this particular row. Investigation technique also 5.1, restrict yourself to 1 SAQ or 1 BAQ and remaining MCQs. Okay, so 5.15 here, 11.3 restrict to 11, 6.36. So row wise you have to check whether you are not overrating or underrating that topic. That you need to check, and then check, go back to table number 3 and go back to table number 1 for recall, comprehension and application levels, whether you are exceeding or underrating. Now see here, because it is 58.5, 29.25, these are kind of marks coming out when we divide 117 by 50%, 25 and 25. But here we cannot achieve that 58.5 marks because we do not have 0.5 marks question in your question paper. Okay, that's why we have to accept this flexibly, that 58.5 you can round up to 59, 29.25 you can round up to 29. Okay, so just for rounding up, we cannot achieve this 58.5. So this was regarding hands-on exercise on blueprinting. Okay, so I'll just summarize. You need to go to blueprint Excel sheet. There are 2 parts, weightage paper 1 and blueprint paper 1, and for paper 2 there will be respective spreadsheets. Then check whether this complete Excel sheet is filled up with weightage. We have already filled for you, you don't have to modify that. Go back to blueprint paper 1, and in this blueprint paper 1, as I have already mentioned, table 1, table 2, table 3 and then table 4 you need to exercise. While exercising table 4 and choosing the questions and distributing the marks, you have to go back again to table number 3 and table number 1 intermittently and check whether you are overrating or underrating the particular level, right? And most importantly, these two columns you have to check always competency wise or group of competency wise. Okay, whether you are exceeding the total permissible allocated marks or not. Don't exceed, you just have to round up. Yeah, this was regarding hands-on exercise on blueprint template, and now we can go back to our video.